It's springtime on the Willamette, and we're with Phil Pirone of Procure and his friend Dave Herber, and Owin Hays, host of the popular Northwest outdoor show, Outdoor GPS. Jon Horak, better known as Fish on John, is looking to put us on some fast-paced catch-and-release sturgeon action.
What I'm doing right now is I'm watching the depth finder, and I'm trying to find a contour line. It's 40 foot on the shoreline, 50 foot where I want to anchor my boat, and 60 feet on the other side, so I'm fishing three different depths. If they're up on the flats, we'll get them. If they're in the middle on the transition, we'll get them. And if they're in the deep, we'll get them. This gives you a little bit more variation opposed to just fishing the flats or just fishing an incline.
Spring Chinook run on the Willamette has been kind of spotty at best. Guys are really struggling for bites. So we're going to take advantage of this catch and release sturgeon fishery. It's been red hot if you know what you're doing. And we're here with my friend Jon Horak. And he's been just pounding fish on a daily basis, using a lot of Procure, which makes me happy. And we're here with Owin from Outdoor GPS and our friend Dave Herber, and we're gonna hopefully put on a show.
Okay, what we're doing right here is I've got just a half a herring. I've cut it in three pieces. I'll make three baits out of it. I've run the hook in like so, half hitch, half hitch. Run the leader through the tail. Fold the tail over. Now my stretchy string just slides up and down my leader. It's just a couple square knots. It's nice and loose. Put it through the center of the tail. Fold the tail over. Stretchy string it. That'll keep your bait from spinning. If your bait's down there spinning, it will not get bit. Chances are it's not going to work. So I want my hook fully exposed, just like that. Okay, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to eject it with Procure Bloody Tuna, which I mix half and half with Sturgeon Frenzy. That's just kind of my thing. All I know about this stuff is if you don't have it, don't go. Just gonna inject it. There's not much coming out. That one will work a little better. There we go. Just like that. We've come down from St. John's Bridge. We're just below the Toyota hole. It's actually what I call the Gray Barn hole, which is kind of my name. I don't think there's really a name to it. West side. There's a million holes here. There's the 100 foot hole. There's a 70 foot drop off. This has got a good contour, so that's why I like it here. But there's one on each side of the river. Right now, these fish seem to be kind of keyed up in the shallow areas. So that's the reason we're here.
I got one. Now, Jon, I like how you use these lighter rod and reel combos.
Yeah, that's 20 pound braid.
They sure are fun.
Yeah. If you're gonna do this CNR fishery, you come down here with a pen
like this,
stick.
A big stick.
You're just grinding away at a little fish. But if you're gonna bring the kids down and you're using the 8 to 20s or something in that range, that's I think 10 to 25 or something. Two-piece Shimano, 20-pound test, absolutely just a ball. And you break a sweat fighting these fish. It's a lot of fun.
Well, and it's not too deep of water, and you don't have to use heavy lead. That's the best part.
Well, that's the best part is the ounce and a half of lead. Oh, bubbles.
Look at that. I'm seeing the sun like that. Beautiful. Very nice.
Come on, young feller.
Quick release.
No sense of bringing them out of the water anyway.
There you go.
Beautiful, thank you.
Yeah, it is.
You're not as little as you thought.
Okay, well, fish on.
Running up river with it.
Oh yeah, a little gator. Hey, hey.
Jon, have you noticed these fish looking really fresh the last week or so?
Extremely fresh. There's no abuse on them at all.
All their scutes seem to be super
scutes
sharp.
Are razor sharp if you look at this fish, if he doesn't try and trade my hand here. Very pretty, very nice fish. His face isn't all beat up. There's no red on him anywhere. Young male sturgeon, beautiful. Okay, well, we're fishing for the white sturgeon, which lives in the ocean, primarily feeds in the estuaries. They come up into the rivers to spawn and will run up into the slack water behind the dams and falls, and primarily larger ones, will spawn, and it's a broadcast spawner, and generally 35 and less is a male, and over 60 is a female, typically. These fish live in the ocean. They migrate back and forth. They'll tag one. It'll show up in San Diego, in the Sacramento. 2 years later, they'll find that same tag in Winchester Bay, Smith, Umpqua. A couple years later, it'll be in the Willamette or the Columbia. These fish migrate all around. This is one of the last great fisheries of this fish that we need to protect. We really need to pay attention to this and protect it.
Welcome back to the Willamette River, where the sturgeon have been especially numerous this year. Possibly a result of this year's large return of smelt, which provided an excellent food source for the Willamette sturgeon.
You know, sitting here talking about why the sturgeon fishery seems to be really picking up on the Columbia and in the Willamette. It's been really good in the Willamette anyway, but on the Columbia in particular, we had one of the best returns of smelt this year that we've seen in, gosh, I don't even know, probably 10 or 15 years, and it's only been closed for 3 years or so on the ESA list. But those fish come all the way up, go up into the Sandy. There was millions of them, and that probably drew a lot of sturgeon up into the system. And now that those fish are done and gone, the smelt, they're still here and migrating through, working into the Willamette, also coming up to feed, water temperatures changing. But it's just got to be a great thing for all these fish that are out there. Smelt, the bottom of the food chain. Those things, everything eats them, and of course, the sturgeon love them. So it's got to be good. Oh, John just hooked up too.
Check it. Thank you, fish.
Well, John, you just had a nice sturgeon on, but you got to explain to me why you like to use spinning reels for this fishery.
This fishery is typically a shaker fishery. One, you don't see or even get as many bites when you're using 30, 40, 50, 60 pound test, 80 pound test like we do on the Columbia. Completely different fishery, a lot more current. You need a lot more lead to stay on the bottom. One, I can use an ounce and a half. I can cast further, use smaller baits, smaller hooks, lighter line. But it's typically a 30 to 36 inch fishery. You're gonna come down here, you're gonna catch, this boat averages 50 to 100 fish a day. If I'm grinding them in on a tiger stick, with the tiger stick, one, I'm not going to hook as many, and two, it's just, you're just grinding them in. It's not really fishing. This way, it's a lot of fun. The rod's folded over. I mean, I take my buddies fishing, and their tongues are hanging out, and their rotator cup needs an x-ray, and it's just a lot of fun. It's just a gas to get out here and do this with light gear.
That's a lot of fun.
Well, we might try a little bit of smelt. Now, this is from the last year that you could actually have, that you could dip smelt off the callus. And it's been 3 or 4 years now, you know. It's been at least 3 years.
Yeah, but if
now.
You vacuum pack them, they should be
yeah,
plenty
no,
fresh.
Yeah, no, vacuum pack
they
them.
They look good.
We did it perfect the day that they were pulled right out of the water, so we'll see if maybe they'll catch a fish too. When I'm setting up smelt, and everybody's got their own way of doing it, I like to just thread them a little bit. Get two or three of them in. That way when you do hook a fish, you'll actually won't lose, most of the time you won't lose your bait, you can get another fish on it. But a little trick is to use your hook and pop a few holes in the belly, because that'll help some of the scent get out. And then right through the back, right out between the eyeballs. So it's just barely hanging out. Generally they'll come up from behind and they'll swallow it. Sometimes they'll grab it from the side. And then just a few half hitches up to the tail. And some people will take and pinch the tail off, some of them don't. I try to take off a couple of them so it doesn't spin around in the water too much. But that's the standard smelt rig. Herring, whatever, same thing. Just like what John's doing here with anchovy, you can cut them up into pieces as well.
He's not oversized, but that's a good fish.
This
we might be for a tussle here.
This is sure a lot of fun, guys, you know? For a fishery where you can't keep them, you can troll around some days on a real slow salmon bite, have one or two bites all day, you can do this and have action all day. It's your choice, but I prefer to do this.
That'll work. That'll work.
Nice.
Can we go for the release?
Come real close to setting the hook here pretty soon.
So you did get that another bite after you picked it up?
Oh, yeah, he's biting right now.
There we go.
That looks good.
Oh, and that fish looks unhappy. What did you
do? Yeah, well, I can feel him spining me with those scoots.
Yeah. Look at that, another one, John. Laid up on his chin.
Smelt caught, Willamette sturgeon.
Watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.